Okay, I got a story for you, right? Check this out. Okay, I've been coaching soccer for the last 10 years. This would be the first year that I took a year off that I'm actually not coaching a team. And it's a little break that I wanted to do, so it gets me time to make these videos, so that's even better for me, right? But in the years that I was coaching, my team would always freaking dominate. We would, like, every year we'd lose to one team, right? Low elementary, and we always freaking lost that team, and that was our rivals, and freaking hated those kids, right? But they had a good coach, and they were a good team, so at least I lost to a good team, so I'm fine with that, right? But I was like maybe fourth year, fifth year. I was going, and a lot of the parents, when they found out who I was and what my team was doing and practices that we were doing, they wanted their kids to be on my team. So I go, and I would only select, I'm sorry, but we'd have to select the best ones, because if you want to dominate, you need to have the best players on the team. Not that I'm only going to pick the best ones. If I see a kid that could get some work and I could make him a better player, I did that, right? And that comes to the story that I'm telling you now. Well, there was this one mom and this kid, and they're like, I want to be on your team. I want my son to be on your team. Well, he was a little fat, right? A little chunky kid. And I could have took these other two kids. There's other two kids. I only have room for one. And I could have took this other kid, a little white kid, really good kid, left-footed. And it's hard to find left-footed kickers, if anybody that coaches soccer understands that. And another little Mexican kid, and he was good too, right? And, well, I said, you know what? I try to be nice. I try to be cool. So what I did was I picked the little fat one, right? Because his mom kept begging me, and he was a cool little kid. So when we would make him stretch him, work him out, run laps, well, he would always have a problem with the exercising and the running, right? It was like, well, you signed up for this sport. I didn't ask you to be on this team. You signed up for soccer. Like, if you wanted to sit down and not do nothing, you could have played chess or checkers or something, right? Play video games. You chose to come out and play soccer. What did you think? So he freaking goes, and he would always come to practice and hungry and tired or everything. Well, one day, him and his mom and his little brother all came to practice with a bucket of chicken, scarfing that shit down in the car. They were freaking just, I was like, don't you know that little son of a bitch has to run? I didn't say that, but don't you know he has to run? Like, dude, you can't eat before you take off running. You get an upset stomach, people, come on. You don't eat before you go swimming, do you? And so him and they're all with chicken hanging out their freaking mouth, freaking hot wing sauce on their forehead and shit. And I didn't say nothing, and whatever. Well, that next weekend comes up, it was around Halloween, and I told the kids we were like 4-0, so we're halfway through the season. The fifth game would be freaking, we were all the way through the season. I mean, halfway through the season undefeated, and I told them, well, look it, if you guys want McDonald's, I'll buy you guys all Happy Meal. You guys win this game, I'll buy you guys all Happy Meal. We got halfway through the season undefeated, we'll go through the rest of the season undefeated, and we'll whip butt, right? And that little kid tells me, well, coach, can you buy me a Monster Mac? I'm like, what the hell is a freaking Monster Mac? I'm an adult, I didn't even know what a freaking Monster Mac. His ass ain't eating Happy Meals, he's eating freaking Monster Macs and shit. So the moral of the story, the little freaking kid freaking quit on me. They never called me, never told me nothing. And once in a while I see them. But see, that's where I get my freaking, every time I see fat people, I'm sorry if you're overweight, but it gets me pissed off. It's like, why do you choose to be like that for? You know what I'm saying? You weren't born all freaking heavy. You know what I'm saying? Well, how come you don't exercise? How come you don't do something with yourself? You know what I'm saying? Oh, well, it's hard. Like, hey, dude, anything that you really want, there's sacrifice in it. You really want a good job, you gotta go to school for years. Anything you really want, you gotta practice and practice and practice and do the best. Okay, same thing with freaking losing weight. Get your fat ass up off the couch, freaking watch what you eat, exercise, whatever you gotta do to get your fat ass, get skinny. And like, I don't like being skinny as I am, and I wish I could gain weight, but you know what? I got a high metabolism, I'm freaking ADD, and freaking ADHD, and everything else there is, hypertension deficit disorder, attention deficit disorder, and freaking, I have no eating problem, but hey, this is me, and that's it, brother, you know what I'm saying? So That's my story about fat people. Not all fat people are like that, but that little kid scarred me. Him and his mom scarred me for the rest of my life. Just thought you guys would like that story. Later.